Let's talk about human intelligence.
Yeah.
Do you have a distinctive East Coast, West Coast type of human?
Well, yeah, there is. I mean, there is a certain East Coast approach to humor. There's certain jokes that they tell each other that are very special. But by and large, I found as a touring performer for years and years and years, when we toured years ago with Spring Thaw, as we went from Victoria right across to end the season in Charlottetown, I never found any real difference, except in Toronto and Winnipeg, the audiences were most reserved. Montreal, they were most explosive. They were just so excited. It was incredible. Every time we went there, we had this, there was double the enthusiasm of anywhere else. But, you know, when I say reserved, that can sometimes be the physical building you're working in can create that. You can go to a city and play in one theater, and it's just incredible, and then go and play in a different theater, and the physical thing, because there's a proscenium stage and there's a bit of a barrier and you're not really in the audience, it can have an effect on the responsiveness. So I don't want to say that, but every time we went through, Winnipeg was always the tougher audience, and then Toronto was not quite as tough because, you know, we built our name here over all those years. But anyway, I didn't find the reaction very different coast to coast.
You're in town, do you have any particular anecdotes that stand out?
Oh, well, I think one of the most incredible moments for a show was in Edmonton. And we were doing a sketch, a half-hour sketch for the air parts, where we kept cutting back to studio, like the anchor man at the desk giving the update on the news events that we were reporting on, and that we saw them unfolding, and then we'd have another update. Well, one of the news anchor people's name was Rhomboid Muckfuster. And when the fellow playing the part, John Morgan, came to say his name, he transposed the syllables. So you can imagine how it came out. Rhomboid Muckfuster came out quite differently. And he just, I've never seen him like that. He just went white with fear and in shock and so stunned at what he'd said.
Did bring the house down?
Oh, well, yeah, it did. It brought me down, and I remember Don Ferguson fell on the stage laughing, and several people were corpsed over each other laughing. It was just it was an incredibly funny moment. And I said that I was leaving because I wanted to get a good seat in the cruiser with the cops after hearing that. But anyway, it was a really funny. That's because it's totally unexpected, and the best comedy is always what's unexpected. I had a night where I fell off. No, I didn't fall off. Somebody else. We were only a blackout, and the girl I was working with vanished. She fell off the stage onto a concrete floor, and crawled back during the blackout, and no one even saw it happen. It was amazing. She was a wreck afterwards. We found her in the fire escape. But nothing. I remember falling down a staircase when I was entertaining the troops in the Sinai Desert. Those are incredible things, going into the Golan Heights and the Sinai Desert UN troops. Yeah. I had an awful experience in Japan at the United Nations Hospital. We were going and performing in the wards, and I went into this wards and I saw all these fellows in their blue pajamas, and I thought they were black American GIs, you know. What did I know? I mean, no one said anything, so I started performing. And the whole ward, you know, and nothing was happening, nothing. And I was doing more, and I was perspiring and trying to make it better and funnier and going. And then they started to laugh. Right near the end, they started laughing. And then when I came out in the hallway, this nurse who was guiding us along, or a Red Cross worker, she said, did you enjoy performing for the Ethiopians? I said, you couldn't tell me that before. I could have at least cut my time. But however, I didn't know they're Ethiopians. They looked like black Americans. You know, they looked like GIs to me. I thought that they were.